Good evening students, welcome back once again and hi, this is Shominan sir. Today I am here to teach you geography. So I hope all of you have watched my last video on chapter number 1, India's size and location, where we have already discussed about India's latitudinal, longitudinal extent, its neighboring countries, which countries they are developing their trade and commerce, etc. So today we will start geography chapter number 2. From chapter number 1 I have given you some question answer and I hope all of you have done it. So chapter number 2, physical feature. What do you mean by physical feature? Actually India is a vast country of very physical feature. Different regions of India, there are mountains, there are plains, there are plateaus. So there is a variation of relief feature. So what are the main reason for the variation? In our country you can see that we have hard rocks which are used in making of monuments like Taj Mahal. Or there are soft rocks which are used for making powder. This rock is called talcum. As well as there are various types of soil found with varied colors. Various types of rocks are found in different area. So what is the main reason for this variation? The main reason for the variation are all due to the different formation of rocks. As the rocks are formed from different minerals or from different ways, the color, the structure, everything varies. Now, an important thing, plate tectonic theory. This plate tectonic theory is an important part of this chapter because nowadays nothing can be discussed apart from this plate tectonic theory. Whatever the formation of landforms from the earth, all are due to this plate movements. So, what is plate? Plate is the rigid lithospheric slabs or rigid and solid crustal layers. Are technically called plates. So the solid structural layers, we have plates under ocean, we have plates under continents. So there are two types of plate, oceanic plate and continental plate. Let's have a focus on the map. So here is the map of several plates of the world. This map again I will show you after one or two slides. That time we will discuss about it in details. So here are North American plate, South American plate, Eurasian plate, African plate, Indian plate, Australian plate, Antarctic plate, Caucasus plate, Pacific plate. So under ocean, under continents, there are solid landforms or structure. These are called the plates. Now movement of plates. These plates are not stable because the top of the earth, if you consider the interior of the earth, the top of the earth is solid, which is called the crust. Under the crust there is mantle, under mantle there is core. So mantle is a semi-liquid or semi-fluid. Over it the crust are solid. This crust, solid crustal layers are called the plates. They are floating on the magma. So there are three types of plates which we will discuss on the next slide. So what are the main movements of the plate? Due to the movements of the plates, folding, faulting and volcanic activity occurs. Folding means, what is folding? When the two plates, they are moving towards each other, the in-between land has been folded or warped up. This is called the folding. So due to this folding, fold mountains can be formed, Himalayas, Alps, Rockies, Andes, all the big mountains of the world are the fold mountains. This is formed due to compression of the two plates from both the sides and the in-between land has been folded up. Now, when the two large land masses or two large plates, maybe oceanic or maybe continental, they are moving away from each other, it stretches. So due to this shear movement, faulting or cracks is developed. Where several types of block mountains or valleys can be formed due to this faulting. And last one is the volcanic activity. So where there are the margins of the plates, several volcanic activities occur. The molten magma comes out and volcanic activity occurs over there. Classification of plate boundary. Just now I have discussion about the types of plate: convergent plate, divergent plate and transformed plate. Convergent means when the two plates are moving towards each other. So as they are moving towards each other, they are called the convergent plate. And when the two plates are moving away from each other, they are called the divergent plate. And when the two plates are sliding each other, they are called the transformed plate. So we focus on the diagram. First, number A diagram, the two plates are moving away from each other. So this is called the divergent plate boundary. This is the plate boundary and these are the two plates. So they are moving away from each other. Now, on diagram number two, the two plates are moving towards each other. They are the convergent plate boundary. And in the diagram number C, the third one, the two plates are sliding each other. So they are called the transform plate boundary. So these are the three types of plate. I hope you have all understood. Now, plate margins of the world, world plate margin. Again, you should focus on this map. Previously, just now I have already shown you, once again I am showing it, the different plates of the world. The earth crust has been divided into several plates: North American plate, South American plate, Eurasian plate, Arabian plate, African plate, Australian plate, Indo-Australian plate, Pacific plate. So several plates are given over here. So this line you can see what that is separating the two plates, they are called the plate margin. So it is a map of the plate margins of the world. And all the tectonic activity occurs in the plate margin. Either these two plates are moving towards each other, it can may have folding, or if it is moving away from each other, folding, faulting can happen over there, or several earthquake movement, volcanic activity, all this activity, tectonic activity occurs in the plate margin area. So from here you will just learn about whatever plates are there. There are seven major plates of the world and several other minor plates are over there. So from this map, important plates of the world are given, including the major plates. Minor plates are not subdivided over here. Few of the minor plates, Caicos plate, Nazca plate, Philippines plate, these minor plates are given. Most of the plates, North American, South American, Eurasian, African, Indo-Australian, Indian plate, Australian plate, Atlantic, Antarctic plate, is the major plates of the world. Now, the concept of Pangaea and Panthalassa. It is a new topic to you. What is Pangaea and what is Panthalassa? When the earth was formed, and when the land masses and the water bodies developed, previously all the continents or the land masses are assembled in one place and it is surrounded by water body. So this continent, supercontinent, is called Pangaea. So Pangaea, it is the supercontinent that exists during late Paleozoic era. Paleozoic era is a period. On this period, all the continents are assembled in one place. And it is surrounded by water called Panthalassa. So it is a supercontinent that exists 250 million years ago. So this is called the Panthalassa. Here is a map of Pangaea and Panthalassa. So Pangaea and Panthalassa. So the entire super landmass, which you can see, it is called the Pangaea. And it has been surrounded by water body called Panthalassa. Now, Pangaea is break into two parts. The northern part is called Laurasia and the southern one is called Gondwana land. So Laurasia, all the continents or the landmass which are present, especially in the northern hemisphere at present, they are the part of Laurasia. And the landmasses which are present in the southern hemisphere at present, or not all are in southern hemisphere, but maximum part which are there in southern hemisphere, they are the part of Gondwana land. The continents are assembled in one place and they started to split. Either they started to move from each other or they move towards each other. And I have already told you, it is all due to the plate movement, convergent plate, divergent plate. So at present, you just imagine the present position of the earth and this position. The present positions of the continents and the previous position. So this is called the Gondwana and Laurasia. And Panthalassa is the water body. From the Panthalassa, at present we are having several oceans like Pacific, Atlantic, Indian Ocean, as well as we are having several seas, are also the Bay of Bengal, Arabian Sea, South China Sea, all are the part of Panthalassa land. So on the next video we will discuss about the other or the next topic, how the formation of the mountains like Himalaya and the other physical features. So today up to this much, and I hope all of you should watch it carefully, as well as you will go through your book. And all of you know that now at present we are all under the threat of COVID-19 or coronavirus. So all of you please stay at home and stay safe. Thank you all. Have a nice day. Good night.